Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Markita if you're new here. So glad that you stopped by today to catch another video. Today's gonna be all about task cards. So this is something new that I had discovered recently through social media. I saw that like task cards were totally a thing. So then I did a little bit of research and I decided to include them with the home management stationery box. You guys seem to love them. That's one of the probably the most loved items from the box. And so I decided to do a full video dedicated to task cards, showing you how to set them up and just showing you what is available and kind of how to use everything. So if you're new here, I hope you'll stick around and consider subscribing. I also hope that you will give me a thumbs up on this video if you enjoy it. So let's jump into this task card situation. If you want to see that, make sure to stay tuned. Alright y'all, so I'm really excited about this video. So I thought what I would do is I would show you guys all of the options and then I would show you how to put together your very own task card system. And so there was one included in the home management stationery box and then some new products just came into our shop. So I thought I would show you guys those as well. And then I'm also going to show you guys how to store all of this stuff because it's going to be something completely new to your system. So you're going to need to have a place to kind of keep it all together. So let's go ahead and get started. So first and foremost, the task cards that were included in the home management stationery box were, and some of this stuff has been used, so you have to pardon me because I actually used some of it to create my own task cards. So it came with this sheet. I actually have this available in, I think, 7 different color schemes and designs. And so basically these are the labels. So this is how they look. And so you'll need these, of course, or you can actually put the wording directly onto the task card. It's up to you, but I'm gonna show you some different ways that you can use this system. But this was a part of the home management stationery box. You also got one of these dashboards with no tabs. You got 3 of the adhesive pockets, and then you also got 3 of the clear cards. So I know these are super popular. You guys have been asking how you can buy more of these. They are coming back to the shop. I'm just trying to get the restock box out and use the quantity I had because my previous vendor had gone out of business. And so I needed a new vendor for these and I have since found the vendor. It's gonna have our logo at the bottom. So I'm really excited about them. And so you'll be able to purchase them in clear. But for now, I do have them in other colors. I have silver, I've got black, white, and gold. And the gold kind of has like a shimmery effect and I thought the silver did, but it's just very subtle. So these are the options that are available to you right now until I do the restock on clear. So these are all great options. So I just thought I would show you that. I'm not gonna use these to set them up. I just wanted to show you what was all available to you. And then I also wanted to show you what else was included in the home management stationery box. Like I said, you got 3 of these adhesive pockets, and then you also got the labels. You got the tabs so that you can put the tabs onto your task card like so, so that you could easily get it in and out of your sheet. And then you also got one of these sheets here. This one is work. I do have 5 of them available. You got the one for home, which is, where is it? I just had it, which is right here. So this is the one that you received in the home management stationery box. I tried to make it as general as possible so you had different looks based on all of these subjects here that I just showed you. I wanted you to have a couple of different options for each subject. And then I also have one for self-care. And then I have one for cleaning. And then I have one for finances. And one for work. So the beautiful thing about these is that they fit very perfectly inside of your adhesive pocket. They fit very well in these. You could use the adhesive pockets to store them all, as you see. All right, and then there's another option that you could use, which is this little system here. I love this so much. This is where I store all of my paper task cards. And then I'm gonna be adding these to the mix as well. So you could use this and just kind of tuck them into one of the pockets here. And this is a great place to store them and put them on your planner cart, or you can put them in your planner caddy or whatever you decide. Keep them in your purse, keep them near you because it's just so compact and small. And then as you can see, you can also fit the task cards in here, which is great. So this can just be literally your task card wallet. and this could be used to store all things task card. And you can even put some task cards in here that you're not using, but you want to use them later. You can use this. This is a great place to store it all. And in addition to this, this is actually real leather, and it's got a little dangle, cute little dangle charm right there. If you don't want that sort of system, we also have these, which is pretty much the same concept. It's a lot cheaper. It's got this little cover page right here. So there isn't a slot here or here. And then you've got slots all throughout here. So this is a great option. You can take a piece of vinyl and you can put task cards on the front. It's slimmer and it's just a great place to store them as well. In addition to this, we do have a task card acrylic holder available in the shop, which is clear. And you can use those to just prop your task cards in. I don't have it up here. I thought I brought it up, but I didn't. And so these are great storage options. I do have something similar to this in the shop that isn't real leather, but it's a great solution as well. And it doesn't have this dangle charm either. It just looks a little bit different. So these are great storage solutions. You can also just take a dashboard and put these clear pockets on top and store them all in here. It's completely up to you. You've got options there. So that's first and foremost how you're going to store all of this stuff. I think that's super important as well. So you've got several options when it comes to that from my shop, and I'm sure there's other shops out there that you can find a solution from as well. So that's first and foremost how to store all of this stuff. Okay, so now I'm going to show you every single thing that's available in terms of task cards. We already talked about the task cards themselves, which are clear, or all of these colors. Again, restock coming soon with our logo at the bottom. These will not have our logo on them. They're just like this. And so these are all five of the task cards that are available to you in terms of the plastic task cards. And then you've also got the paper task cards, which I adore as well. And so these are the task cards that are the same size, and you've got lots of different options for them. And so let me show you how they look in your planner. And so I've got them kind of set up the same exact way on top of one of our frosted dashboards that have no tabs. So it doesn't have a tab. It just sits right in your planner. I do have them with the tab as well. And eventually we will restock the dashboards, the actual divider dashboard. So this is what I have it on. Same thing as this. And so these are all of the paper task cards. As you can see, I put one on this side and I put one on this side. So that's the cool thing about these. Again, I have it in frosted and clear. So frosted, of course, is frosted, so you're not gonna be able to see as clearly, but in my opinion, you can still see very clear. And you can put them on both sides. So I've got several different variety of the paper task cards as well. So I use paper and I use the plastic ones. And I think they work very well together. And I love the menu planner ones in particular because I slide those out and then I take them and I put them in here and I've got menus already ready to go. So I can just say, hey, you know what? I don't feel like trying to figure out a menu. Let's just use the same menu that we used 2 weeks ago or a month ago or last, you know, 6 months ago or whatever. So I keep those stored in here, and that has been working out so well. And so I've got them in the to-do list. So you can slide them in that way, because as you can see, the wording goes this direction, or you can do like I do and I just slide them in that way because you are going to write on it that way. So I've got the to-do list ones, and then I've also got the meal planning ones, which I just showed you. I've got planner routines, and I've got some mauve header ones that are lined grid. And I've got a ton of other varieties of these. There are a few versions in 3x3, which will not fit in here. These are the 2x3. So don't get them confused when you're looking at the website. Okay, so we talked about task cards. We talked about how you're gonna store them all. We talked about these adhesive pockets, which again came with the home management system, three of them. The dashboard came. You also got three of the plastic cards. You got a ton of stuff in the home management box. So stay tuned for the restock. I know you guys have been asking, so you must be on my group or else you will probably not be notified. It'll probably sell out in the group. So you definitely want to join my Facebook group if you want one of the boxes. Okay, so in addition to this style, which is kind of top loading, I call it vertical, we've got the horizontal one, or like, not really side loading. It's just different. So it's got a little lip here, as you can see, right here. It's got that little lip. They're a little bit bigger than these. I love these because they're snug. So the card is going to fit perfectly in them. As you can see, it's perfect. And then that's why I created this tab here, because I felt like it's gonna be, might be a little bit of a challenge to get it in and out. So you can use this to kind of slide it in and out. and it just makes for easy removal. And it also makes you be, you know, it allows you to be able to see what is this task card. You see that this task card is a cleaning task card, so it just makes it easy to slide in and out. So I love these. And then also, if you're going to use these, you see how much bigger they are, then you'll only be able to fit two per page depending on the size. I think for a classic size, for this size, which is half letter, for A5 you can fit three. I think mini you can fit two, and I think half sheet or skinny classic you can fit two as well. I'm not quite sure, but you do get three. And so as you can see, these are bigger. So the box came with this size, which is this size, and these are an addition in the shop. And then we also have an index card size, which is considerably bigger than this. So I just wanted to show you the two main options when it comes to task cards. So again, if you did this one right here, you'd want to put it in this way, because you can't, you're not gonna be able to shimmy the, I mean, you can actually put the whole thing in this way. You could do that. But you probably want to put this sticker here on the side, and then you may even want to position these differently. So I just think this is a better look in terms of being able to easily slide it in and out, and also just being able to see what it is that you're trying to accomplish. This view to me is just a better view. So we've talked about a lot of things so far. So let me make sure that I'm not missing anything. So now let me show you some new things that are available that just came in today. It is Monday, I'm bulk filming, so you probably won't see this till later this week, but we've got some transparent sticky notes. I know a lot of people, when it comes to task cards, because with my task card system, with the sticker system, which is still great, you're pretty much probably just gonna use this for reference. These are repositionable, unless you order it in glossy, which means you can take the sticker off and position it in your planner on one of your spreads. If you want to know, hey, Tuesday I need to clean the floor, so you want to kind of move this around, you want to take these off and put these back on when you're completed with that task. These don't make it as easy, so this is just a great reference system. But if you want a system where you can kind of pull things off and put it in your planner on that specific page, and then when you're done doing that task, you can put it back on the task card, which is what a lot of people do. These are great. So these are new to the shop, so I've got them in these colors here. So these are great for color coding. So if you want to say your home is all this color, your business is all this color, your cleaning is all this color, your school is all this color, and so on and so forth, you've got a ton of options here. It's got this little punch here that fits in certain planners, so that's great. And it's also got a ruler on the other side, so these are fantastic. So I did order these in two different color schemes. The other color scheme was sold out. I'm hoping they restock soon, and I'll order those so you have different options, and you have more options as well if you pair them together. So as you can see, one side is pretty much transparent. It is a little bit of white there, but it's pretty much transparent. When you put in your planner, it's going to be more transparent than you see here. So these are the same color. One is just dots, which I love. I love these. And one are squares. And eventually we will have the full color one if you decide that you want that option as well. It's just not available just yet. But I adore these because they've got a little bit of color at the top there. And the circle is just so cute. And you can actually fit more circles then you can fit squares, as you can see. I mean, I probably could have moved the spacing around, so you probably can fit the same amount if I had just positioned it differently. So I love them both so much. So I'm probably gonna be using these as opposed to using the sticker sheets for now. But again, over time, you guys know I'm constantly switching things up, so it could change. And so these are great. Like I said, you're gonna go ahead and overlay them with these stickers here based on the subject, and then you'll be able to pull these off and put them in your planner wherever they go. Stick them on the page depending on whatever that day is of what you want to do. If you're using a color code system, you know gray represents whatever, and then you'll be able to see it once it's completed. You can take it and put it right back on your task card. So that's the beauty of having these sticky notes. That's why I was frantically searching for a vendor for some sticky notes like this, so that way you could use the system a little bit different if you don't want it just for reference. So these are available. Love these. And this is probably what I'll be using in this video to set up the task cards. Okay, so I just wanted to show you how they actually look on the task cards. And then we have these options. These are new to the shop as well. These are sticky notes as well. And so if you wanted to use this system, you could, and it's basically the same, except these are not transparent, of course, and so it's going to look a little bit different. So you can kind of, you know, put one here, and then you can put one, you know, on the other side if you want to maximize the space. It is completely up to you. So I could do something like that, and then these stickers are so perfect, and the size of them are so perfect that you could easily take them And they are made with transparent mats, so you're probably not gonna be able to see that. But these are transparent matte stickers, which I love transparent matte more so than glossy. I don't know. I just really love the transparent look. I love the feel of them. So you could easily take this and put it right here, y'all. Don't y'all just love task cards? Isn't that the cutest thing ever? So you have multiple options. I just showed you four. So you can choose what works best for you. And so we're just gonna kind of play around with them today because I'm just so intrigued by this whole thing. And then I'm gonna show you, you know, kind of how you would use them in your planning system. So I just wanted to show you all of the options that are available to you. And so these sticky notes here come in two different color schemes, the gray and then like the rose gold, but like a peachy gray combination. I love them both so much, so much. So this is all of the new stuff. So I just thought that I would show you that since it came in today. I thought it was perfect timing. And so we're gonna go ahead and create some different task cards now. So again, you already saw this option, the sticker option. I don't feel the need to really do a sticker option because I already had it here for you. And so this with the word overlay, these were in the home management stationery box. They fit very well with the whole color scheme of it. And then these are stickers, again, repositionable stickers. So you can technically take them off of here and put them in your planner and then back on here if you want, but it's not as easy as these. And some people prefer the sticker because it doesn't move around. It's not as floppy. It's not gonna come up off the paper. And of course, sticky notes do. So they may catch as you're putting them in and out of the plastic adhesive pocket. So it's just up to you, but there's different scenarios and I wanna talk to you about the pros and cons of each. So that's why I'm kind of trying to mention that to you. So I'm not going to show you this method because you can see it right in front of you and it's kind of self-explanatory with how you do it, but I still want to do one just so I can show you guys. And again, I already have my pockets on top of the dashboard. I've got three on the front and I've got three on the back, so I'm ready to go. Okay, so first and foremost, what you're going to do is you're going to, again, the shop now has these, but this is a full page as opposed to just eight of them. So you've got more options here. And so this was just for the box. This size was just for the box. So I have them in glossy. So first you want to determine what are going to be your sections. And again, I tried to make sure that these matched up with all of these. I only have five of these available, five different varieties right now, but eventually we'll have more and they'll kind of be general to where they'll fit underneath some of these different subjects. So I definitely wanted a cleaning. And so you're gonna take it and we're just going to create one today. I'm not gonna create all of my task cards. And then you're gonna pick whichever one you want. All of the stickers pretty much go very well with these. And once I get my transparent, I'm gonna purchase or see if I can find a vendor for a full transparent clear or white one. And then one with different colors. Kind of like, you know, this would be just the whole color of it. So I'm gonna try to source some different options for that, but first will probably be just a full transparent one because I feel like those will go very well on some of these colored cards. But for now, all of this does go very well. It's just that, you know, you're gonna wanna pick and choose the right colors. Like the gray would go very well with the gray. I mean, you know, it's just basically up to you and what you like. That's why the clear is so popular, is because you don't have to really decide. All the colors go well with the clear, and the clear is just classic in my opinion. Okay, since I already started this one, we're gonna go ahead and put, actually, yeah, I'm just gonna remove this one because this one wouldn't be considered gem. I just like the look of the round, little sticky notes, the cutest thing. So first and foremost, you're gonna take this, and I'm hoping you can see what I'm doing. I probably should get a darker background just so you can see how to put it on. Very easy though. These are just like all of our other fold over tabs that we have available in our shop. You're just gonna take it on one side, make sure it's centered. Now, if you want to do it this way, you could do it this way. Like I said, if you're going to use the other adhesive pockets, and you actually could stagger it. So you could put one here, and one here so that you could see them. If you're going to put them all in one pocket, it's completely up to you. But I'm going to just center it here and just eyeball it. Make sure it sticks and then take it and always line it up to the bottom of this side. And again, these are glossy. I have them in matte as well. And I also have them in blank if you want to write in your own. See, perfect, very easy. Okay, so now that we've got that done, now's the fun part. Like I said, I just love these so much that I'm gonna do one with these first. I might do two versions just because, I don't know. I'm just feeling really inspired right now. So I think I could, like I was doing before, take one and put them on either side. going. So I think you could fit about three. So cute. It's just a different sort of look. And so that is done. And so now we're gonna use this one for cleaning. So we'll pull the cleaning one. And you may have multiple, because as you can see, you've got a lot of options here for cleaning. You may want to use all of them. So you may have to have multiple of these, or you can even add more on the backside if you're pulling these out and putting them in your planner. Or even, because this is double-sided, you could just have two sides, which is cool. So they're very, some of them are very general and some of them are very specific. So I am going to take, I want to have one general. Actually, do I just want to just do all the rooms? Let's just do all the rooms. So I'm just going to try to center it as best as I can. So we'll do bathroom, kitchen, just the main rooms that I know we do on a consistent basis. Bedroom. See, as you can see, even though it's a clear mat, it looks like a actual clear. It's regular clear. Once you get it overlaid on top of the sticky note. And let's do living room. And let's do laundry. And let's do one more. It's probably gonna be the dining room. And let's do the office, right? Cause I can kind of lump dining room in with kitchen in my mind. Isn't that so stinking cute? I love it. I'm obsessed already and I haven't even put it in my planner yet. Okay, let me find my planner so I can show you how you would use it. Okay, we're gonna do another one too, just so you know. So again, you'd have this, you'd keep its lid in here, and it's just aesthetically pretty too. You know what I mean? Like it's just gorgeous. So you keep it in there, and of course you'd keep it in whatever section of your planner you want. In the home management stationery box and on the regular sheet, this one doesn't show it. This was the first version, then I changed it. And I said, you know what? It'd be cool to have one that said tasks. So I have one of the fold over tabs that says tasks. So you can put it at the top and you can see it in your planner that this is your task, you know, card section. And so you'd put it wherever you'd want to put it. And so when it's snapped in your planner like this, then you'll be able to slide this out very easily. Okay, oops, I should have had you more in the frame. And then you take it and you say, okay, on Sunday, I want to clean the office. So that's the beauty of having the sticky note situation as opposed to the sticker situation. Because you can just have that there and say, okay, we're going to clean the office in that day. And then once you're done with it, that task, if you want to see it completed, because it'll be here, you kind of want to have... You want people to see what tasks you're completing. So they should all be gone off of here and scheduled in your planner. And then as you're starting to do them, you can put them back in here. So that way, when you see this, you know that that particular task has been completed. Whoever came up with this system is just awesome, because this is so cute, but at the same time, it's functional. So that is the first task card set that we're gonna create. We're just having fun with task cards today, y'all. And so let's go ahead and create another one. So let's do, we already did cleaning. Let's do, do I have one for financial? Yep, I do. I have one in here. Oh, I have one on here too, so I don't even have to open that. So let's do one for finances. So same thing, you could choose whatever color you want, or you can just stick with the clear like I am. And let's go with this because it's already here. We're gonna have to move this down a little bit. So I'm gonna take this off just temporarily and I'll probably reconfigure that whole situation. Okay, finances. Okay, fold it over, very easy. Okay, so now that we've got that there, I'm going to add this back. I feel like I need to move some things around because I like to have my spacing look a certain way. Y'all, I might just have to upload this video Monday, today, along with my plan with me, because I'm just so excited about this. And I feel like you guys need to see this like ASAP. Okay, I'm a stickler for symmetry and I like things to look. Even though you're gonna be pulling this off and putting it back on, that's just how my mind works. Isn't that so cute? Okay, so now we need to pick our finances wording, which is right here. Then you're gonna pick whichever ones work best for you. Again, this is a situation where you could do it double-sided because you probably have more of these that you wanna use other than the five that I put here. But for me, I'm just gonna pick my top five. And I think I'm gonna grab some tweezers to get this more precise. And again, if you wanna color code this, you can do that. If you just want like all the finances to be all this color. And so that way when you put in your planner, you know that this color represents the finances section. And of course you'll wanna make a key for that so that way you know what each color represents. And you're more than welcome to do that. So I'm gonna do pay bills just because it's general. And I wanna only keep it to the number that I have here. And I'm gonna do budget meeting. Okay, then I'm gonna do payday. Okay, and then I'm going to do goals. No, I don't want to do, no. I'll do check-in. Okay, and then I'm going to do, I'm going to do transfer money because I do like to invest and I probably will eventually maybe add a part two finances and maybe add investing to that. But I like to transfer money to various places, into savings and into Acorns, which I love. And I have a link below for Acorns if you're interested. I love Acorns. That is where I do all of my investing. And I don't really like specifically invest. I more so just keep the money in there and it accrues interest. And it's just a great place to kind of hold on to money. And you can also invest if you so choose. So I love Acorns. So I don't know why I'm like a stickler for things to look a certain way. So don't you love that? Tell me you don't love that. Tell me that's not the cutest thing ever. If you can see it, that to me is just so adorable and it makes you want to use it, but yet at the same time it's still functional. So you would stick it in just like so. You can have different looks. You don't have to just do this look or this look. You can do a variety so you'll be able to see all of that together. Because lastly, we're gonna do this one. Just because it's just fun, like why not? So again, it's the same concept. You'd be able to slide it out like so. And you'd be able to take your planner and you'll be able to take it off depending on what you need to do. You need to pay bills on Thursday, take it off. And you'll put it right here. Pay bills, bam, oop, done. Then when you're done, you take it off, you put it back on here so you can see that it's completed and just to put it back where it belongs. So this is a great option for tasks. I love it so much just because I'm a stickler. I'm gonna put it back up to the top where I had it and plus I need to take a picture from my thumbnail and I want it to look good for the photo. I love these. So cute. So let's go ahead and move on to the last one. Slide this back in here. It pulls in and out easily. I know I was a little bit concerned about that with the sticky note, with it being, you know, floppy a little bit, but as you saw, it comes in and out rather easily. Just about the same as the sticker. So let's choose the last one. Let's see, home, work. How about work? Work. Okay, now, only thing is, do I have one for work? I may not have one of these on here for work. Yeah, I don't. So, what could we do? How about this? I'll print it later and add it to the top later. So just know that on this one, I'm not gonna be adding the top foldover tab because I need to get it from the shop downstairs. Okay, so I'm gonna tighten this up a little bit more so I can add another one. And I kinda wanna show you guys how many you could add here comfortably, just in case you're wondering. You know, maybe I should start from the top, but leave room for that, for the fold over tab. Okay, so I think that 5 is just the number that's gonna fit best. I remember you could do it this way as well. I'm not sure how many fit that way. And you could utilize the backside. So you've got, technically, you've got 10 that you could fit comfortably. Okay, so I am now going to go ahead and add all of those things. I'm gonna do some general, like work is general. I'm trying to think, how did I do the other one? Do I want, okay. You gotta decide if you want the color on that side or if you want the color on this side. It's completely up to you. I think I kinda want the color on this side just to stay consistent. As you can see, these fit perfectly. And you could take these and put them directly on the task card itself if you're just using it for reference. So let's see, I want to file. Okay. I'm gonna do it to buy because I buy a lot of stuff from the for the shop. Okay, and I'm going to do email. I'm gonna do one for social media also, which is what I need because I need like Patreon, you know, Instagram, YouTube, stuff like that. So I'm gonna do that. And then lastly, I'm going to do brainstorm for like ideas. I think this is the cutest stinking thing ever. I'm obsessed with all of it. I am, I have to say. You're gonna see this a lot in upcoming videos. Lots of different videos on how to use these, how to better use them. More of these created. I'm sure you're gonna see a lot more to come in the future. Look at that. How awesome is that, y'all? I'm really excited about this. And then don't forget about these. These actually came in the home management stationery box. They're stickers as opposed to sticky notes. So you've got multiple looks here. So I really enjoyed this video. This is probably my favorite video today so far. I did 3 videos prior to this video. And this one probably is my fave. Only because I'm so glad all this new stuff came in so I could show it to you on this video. And I just think you guys are really gonna love the new options here. So that's it for this video, guys. So let me again show you how it will look in your planner. And you may even just wanna use all in one color. Maybe you just don't like the other colors and you don't color code. You could do that too. That's why I wanted to be very neutral in the color scheme. So you could choose this, this, and then when it comes to these, you just will have lots of them left over because I don't have them in all one color. But hopefully eventually I'll be getting the all white ones or all this color ones. And so you'll be able to use those as well. So stay tuned for that for the future. But y'all, again, there will be one label at the top that says tasks. So you'll be able to see at the top that this is for tasks. Just like these other top divider dashboards or these other divider tabs at the top, you'll be able to see that that is what this is for from the top. So that is available now. So that is it for the video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. All right, guys, this is so much fun. So that is it. So just again to recap, there are paper task cards that are already pre-printed and they're printed on a linen cardstock, super cute. I love them right now and I still use them right now in my planner system. And then you've got the task cards that involve a plastic card that you're able to kind of customize based on your needs, make it look cuter, very functional. It's very laser focused on what you actually need to accomplish. So both of them are great for multiple reasons. And so again, these came with the home management. Stationery box. It came with the labels here. It came with these labels. It came with the wording, 3 plastic cards, 3 adhesive pockets, restock coming soon. That's why I'm sharing this with you. And it came with a ton of other things so that you can make your task cards look just like this. And then if you just want a different option, you're not quite sold on the whole sticker concept, which is removable and you could put it in your planner, just like I showed you the sticky notes. It's just a little more complicated, but there's still a great option. I love the stickers and there's probably more options for you in terms of the color. So this block color over here, you'll be able to find exactly what you're looking for, because I've got them in gray, all black, all pink, all, you know. So if you don't want all of this busy color, you just want one color, then the sticker is going to be a great option for you. Then we've got the sticky note option with the circle or the square, and then we've got the rounded sticky notes. And those are all of your options, you guys, and I'm so excited about this whole thing. And so I'm going to keep them in my planner. This will probably go in the monthly section, just because I have this in the weekly already. I still haven't decided yet, but I am using both of them, and so I have to decide which one, based on when I start using them, is going to work best for me to keep in my weekly section. I also like that color there, just that pop of color, but I love the neutral of this, so I'm torn between them. That's why I'm going to put them both in my planner. So I think they're great systems. And also, just take note, if you do choose a color, then the color will be in here, as opposed to the clear, you'll see color here. And so you'll see, oh, that's so cute. I could have done that too. I mean, there's so many options when it comes to this whole task system thing, y'all. It's like, why didn't I know about this before? So I'm just glad I know about it now. So you've got just a ton of options that you can put in here, interchangeable. As your look changes, as your spread changes, you could easily, if you use the sticky note option, pull these off and put them on here. Whereas if you do the sticker option, you're not going to want to create another set of these. Again, clear is classic because it goes with everything. So you just got multiple options based on your preference. So hopefully you guys love this all. I adore them. Let me know if you guys have any questions. I would love to hear from you. All of this stuff, including the home management ones, are available in the shop right now. So you don't have to wait for the box to restock for that. You can purchase them now if you choose to. And then once I restock the box, the clear will be in the box. And I will be getting the new clear ones with our logo on them very soon. So you'll be able to have more clear if you want clear. And then I am working on creating more of these stickers. Y'all hear that thunder? For now, I've just got finance, self-care, work, home, and clean. Those are the ones I have now. And as you see, I have a ton of them left based on even the ones I already used. So there's some that are very focused and laser focused on specific tasks, and there's some that are just vague. So you can choose between what works best for you. So that is it for the video, guys. I talked all things task cards. I also shared with you guys some storage solutions. Again, these storage solutions are available, as well as the task card acrylic holder, and then a cheaper version of this that doesn't have all this extra stuff going on, so that you can store all of this fabulousness. And I'm just excited to put this to use, and I hope you guys are as well. So thank you guys so much for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did. Hopefully you got a little inspiration out of it. Comment below and let me know what you think. I would love to hear from you, and I hope that you guys will come back and join me for another video, in which case I'll see you then.